If you ever need to pull data from other Google Sheets to your current sheet, you can do this with the import range function. You can even append data from multiple sheets with import range. Now, the advantage of this function is that it can be embedded inside other functions. It's also a simple function to use, so let me show you how it works. This is the sheet I want to import data to. The data I want to grab is sitting in a file called HR Information. It has two tabs. The first one is HR 2010, so it has the people that have an entry date until 2010, and then HR 2020 has the rest. I want to grab the information from these tabs and bring it into this sheet. Now, your first step is to grab the URL of the sheet you want to get the data from. So in my case, it's HR information. You can get the URL directly from here. You just don't need that edit part. So just grab everything until edit, press Control C, go to the sheet you want to bring in the data to, type in an equals import range. I can see it right here. So let's press tab. All it needs is the spreadsheet URL and the range that you want to import. So the spreadsheet URL needs to go in quotation marks. Press Ctrl V to bring it in, close the quotation mark. Next is the range. Now, if you don't mention a sheet name, it's going to bring in data from the first sheet. So let's say I put in A1 until D10. So notice I'm also putting the range in quotation marks. Now, when I close the bracket and I press enter, and if it's the first time that you're connecting to another sheet, you get this message. You need to allow access to be able to grab the information. So I'm going to click on allow access, and now I get this in here automatically. If I want to be sure that I'm getting it from the right sheet and I don't care about the order of sheets, I have to put the sheet name in there, just like we see in the help here. So if I put in HR 2010, and there was a space between the HR and 2010, so then I need the exclamation mark, right? So just like we see here. Now when I press enter, I'm sure that it's coming from HR 2010. So let's see if I change this to 2020, it's coming from the data from 2020. Now, if you want to be sure that you're grabbing everything till the end, what you can do is remove that end reference. So the row number of the end reference here. Just remove that, press enter, and then you make sure that you include everything. So let's say we add something to the other sheet. If I go to the bottom of this one and I just add LG here, press enter, go back to my import range and just wait a second, we can see it right here. Okay, so it pulls it through automatically. Now, if you want to make this dynamic, you can. We could, for example, add a data validation here and select which tab we want to import. So if I go to data, data validation, and I want a list of items, I just type in my items, it's HR 2010, comma, HR 2020. I'm going to reject input if it's not from my list and click on save. I want to be able to select HR 2010 and I get the data automatically here. Well, one thing I can do is just to reference this part from my dropdown name here. I'm also going to make my formula a bit simpler by taking the URL that I copied before, so I'm just going to copy this again and put it to the side somewhere. I'll put it right here. This way you can reference it. And that's another advantage of Google Sheets, is that you can connect to different sheets depending on which cell you reference and which link you have in that cell. So now I can actually replace this whole part with a cell reference here. And now when I press enter, everything will continue to work as before. What I want to do is to update this to reference this. So the part that I need to make a cell reference is only the text here. So I'm going to remove that and go to the side here, type in an and because I'm connecting a cell reference to text, click on this, press enter. I get 2010 data. If I switch my view here, I get 2020 data. Okay, so that's how easy it is to use import range, but now you might be wondering, how can I append these two together? How can I get them all in one list? Well, you can do that also with import range. So let me show you. If I go to the site here and start with import range, we practically need to do what we did before. I'm going to select, this is my URL, my range string. I'll start with the first sheet, which was HR 2010 exclamation mark, and I'll go with A1 until D50. Now, when I close the quotation mark, close the bracket, and I press enter, I get the data, right? Just like we saw before. But I also want to bring in the other data from 2020. So check this out. I'm going to copy this, go to the end here, add a semicolon. The semicolon is array syntax for adding the next data set below the current data set. So if I paste this again, everything else remains the same except this is my other tab, which is 2020. Now you can't press enter right now because if you do, it's not going to work. Check this out, I get an error. What you need to do, because it's an array now, you have to put it in the curly brackets. Starting right after the equal sign, I'm going to open the curly bracket. At the end, I'm going to close the curly bracket. Now when I press enter, it's going to load both data sets. But look at this. Because I went until 50, it's adding a bunch of empty rows, and then it's adding the next one. Now, I could go exact, right? I could say, well, this one only has rows until 21, the 2010 only has rows until 12, and only restricted to these rows to get them right below the other one. But you probably want to stay flexible. This is when you can combine the import range function together with the query function. So if we start here with query, the query function is quite a simple and very powerful function to use, but you have to know the syntax first. And this is something that we're going to cover in more detail in the next video. Wait for the next video if you want to know how query works. For now, I'm just going to show you the solution. The data that we want to import is our import range. The query itself is, in quotation marks, is select, because we want to bring everything, star. So this means that just bring all the columns, but we want to skip the empty cells. So where? Now here we have to think about what our flag is. Well, I can say if you come across an empty cell in the first column, then exclude that. And to write it for the query function, to understand what the first column is, you have to reference it with COL for column and then the column index number. So that would be column 1. You can't use the syntax A, B, and C. That only works if you're using the query function inside your current spreadsheet, but we'll cover more of that next week. Just remember, whenever you're importing external data and you happen to use the query function, you need to reference it in this way. So where column 1 is not null. Okay, so you should include everything where it is not null. Now I'm going to close the quotation mark, close the bracket, and now when I press enter, I get the data, I get the first one below the next one. Now notice the headers came as well. In this case, it's an easy fix. I can just ignore the headers. So for my range, instead of starting from A1, I'm going to start from A2 and start this one from A2 as well. Now when I press enter, they're going to be right beside one another and the headers are excluded. So all I have to do is just copy and paste the headers in as values. So Control Shift V, and I have appended the data set. And it's really easy to add more data sets. You just have to repeat the syntax here. So that's how you can use the import range function to grab data from different spreadsheets. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, do give it a thumbs up. And if you like what you see, consider subscribing. And I'll see you in the next video.